The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today we come together to give thanks for the life of Bill Ewan, who has gone on before us into the world of God's eternal light, while we are glad for him as he returns to his Father, and all the suffering of this world has been taken away, we feel the immense sadness of the parting. Death is always a mystery, whether life is long or short. But Christians believe that whenever it comes, it is never the end, but is always a new beginning. We know this because Jesus went down into the darkness of death and came back from it like the sun in full strength. In this, he promises new life for all people. Friends, for this reason, we have come together today, in this time and in this place. We come because we loved Bill, and we continue to hold him deep, deep down within our hearts, cherishing his memory and holding him close. Here we will remember him. We will celebrate his life and all that he gave to this world. We come here each believing human life is valuable, that love and happiness, that precious moments and priceless memories, which each and every life contains, live on and endure forever. We come here celebrating and remembering Bill's life, a life lived with music and joy, with love and time for everyone and anyone. The gifts which he offered to us all are never lost to us. The creativity he brought to us in his life, in his relationships, endure within our own lives and travel with us, keeping us and holding us into the future and then eternity. Our lives are more wonderful, more exciting, more memorable, more joyful, because we spent at least part of them with Bill. So let us begin this service as we sing together the first hymn. And that is the hymn, "The Day You Gave Us, Lord, Has Ended."
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord of life and conqueror of death, you are our help in every time of trouble. In the presence of death, you comfort those who mourn. We bow before you, believing you bear our grief and share our sense of loss. Give us the grace to worship you and to trust in your goodness and mercy. Assure us that because Christ lives, we shall live also, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus, our Savior, has taught us that life is eternal and that love cannot die. So death is only a horizon, and a horizon is only the limit of our current sight. Eternal God, open our eyes to see more clearly and draw us close to you, that we may know that we are nearer to those who have gone before us, who are with you. You have told us that you are preparing a place for us. Prepare us also for that happy place, that where you are, we may be also. Loving God, in our pain, we remember with sorrow how we have failed one another and grieved your heart. In your kindness, forgive our past sins, set us free from guilt, and make us strong to live lives of love. God of grace and power, send your Holy Spirit among us, that we may hear your promises and know them to be true. So let all here receive the comfort and the peace that they bring, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord, to whom shall we go? Your words are words of eternal life. The Bible, through the ages, has offered words of comfort to those who seek them. Hear now the word of God in the hope that it speaks to your soul and holds you in God's loving embrace. A reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 3. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to search and a time to give up, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak. God has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the human heart. I know that everything God does will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it, and nothing can be taken from it. This is the word of our Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Friends, we come today together in remembrance, carrying with us our sorrow, but also our memories and our thanks for Bill Ewan, a beloved husband, adored father and grandfather, and friend to all gathered here today. We take time now to remember him with thanks and hopefully even a little joy in our hearts that we have had the honor and the privilege of knowing him and sharing even part of our lives with the wonderful, friendly, funny, accomplished, caring and giving man that was and always will be Bill. Bill leaves behind his mark on this world that can never, ever be erased, will never be forgotten, whether in his family and all the love and memories that they will hold forever, or in his music, a permanent gift to all those who continue to hear it. Bill was born and brought up in Milton of Balgonie, a place he always had fond memories of and stories to tell. He was one of three children, with a brother Robert and a sister Gina. His family knew heartache early on when his dad died at the too young age of 47. After this, Bill had to step up and go to work, as at the time Robert was off doing his national service. He worked hard and he worked early in the morning and late at night to help the family and to continue to pay for his music lessons, which he began at only 5 years old. Bill then left school at 15 and went to work in the mine head, and after a few years there, moved to the sawmill at Milton of Balgonie. It was when he was working there that he and Jean met. They met because Jean's brother Ian and Bill were good friends. Bill was even Ian's best man, and the rest, as they say, is history. Bill then went to work for a fencing company, a job that he absolutely loved, as it involved working with wood and working with his hands. Bill was very skilled when it came to wood, and even though the company had a joiner on hand, if the boss wanted anything done, it was always given to Bill, and he was only too happy to do it. Although it will be no surprise to anyone here that Bill was constantly making sure that nothing ever happened to his hands. Work was one thing, but he couldn't jeopardize his music. Bill worked there for many years, but he did have a career change. He went into insurance, but it wasn't for him, and after only 6 weeks, he was back at the fencing company. The problem was, he said he was more inclined to give the people he dealt with half a crown than take it off them. I bet the customers who had Bill for those 6 weeks, thank God. He retired at 60 after having a heart attack, but this meant that he had more time to spend with his two great loves, his family and his music. Jean and Bill married in 1964 and began their long and happy life together. In time, their family grew, having two sons, Don and Roy. Bill and Jean had a wonderful life and enjoyed each other's company, whether here at home or on their travels. And even in later years, the magic never died. The care never went away. When Bill would come home late at night, sometimes he would sleep in another room so as not to disturb Jean, who would be sleeping, or at least had the intention of sleeping. She would put a hot water bottle in the bed, in the spare bed, to warm it up for him. But ever the joker, Bill said one day, "You might have warmed up the pajamas too." And sure enough, the next time, the pajamas were wrapped around the hot water bottle too. They enjoyed holidays together in Germany and Austria for walking, and of course, as many holidays as possible to visit the family in Denmark. Bill was a great dad. And when the boys were young, even though he worked and played music, he made sure that he was always around. He could turn his hand to anything and was always there to help the boys out, something that continued throughout his life, building things over in Denmark for Roy and here in Colton for Don. He even built he and Jean's house. And when his family grew again to include Carol and Helly and Jack and Charlie and Annie and Emma, this gave him another great joy in his life. And a week never went by without him speaking to his grandkids, because he really did live for them. Now, it would be impossible to speak of Bill without mentioning his music. Throughout his life, he had a passion for it, starting at only the age of 5 and playing for Scottish country dancers since he was 16. He just loved music, particularly Scottish, but he was interested in lots of different genres. In many ways, it was his music that kept him young. Not only the creativity of it, but all the many people that he met and the many places that he traveled to. He played in Austria and Germany and Holland and America, Ireland, Australia, and many other places. And in particular, he spent a lot of time on the Scottish Islands and Shetland. And Jean went with him whenever she could. In later years, one of the things that gave Bill the most pleasure was his work with young musicians and in the St. Andrew's Summer School. He was dedicated to encouraging and supporting young people in their passion for music. He was simply known as Granda Bill to so many of them. Although it should be said he was also known as Bill Ewan MBE to some. Now, I'm sure that we all agree here that Bill was deserving of some national recognition, but this MBE stood for Bill Ewan Mars Bar Eater. I'm told it was a close-run thing between family, music, and Mars bars in Bill's affections. Bill lived an incredibly full life, whether it was family or work or music. But he always had time for people too. He played music in an old folks' home and said that even just one tap of their foot made him feel so happy to know that he had given them a little bit of happiness. He loved time with friends, whether that was his regular meetings for coffee, his many, many friends across the world through music, or indeed the ladies who always accompanied him to the church coffee morning, or as they became known, Bill's harem. And how could we forget the gift he gave the world in his lockdown videos, which led to a CD recording with all the proceeds going to charity, in particular the British Heart Foundation and for this church. It is impossible to fully describe the life of anyone in a eulogy, much less someone like Bill, who took every moment that God gave him and made the best of it. In the short time that I knew him, I was always glad to see Bill. For in every group, in every room that he was in, there was an air of delight, of fun, of laughter. Everyone was always pleased to be in Bill's company. He loved life. And those who had the honor of knowing him let a little bit of that rub off on them too. He was never an old man. His music, his thirst for life, and his trademark, trendy, bright clothes, always kept him young. We as a church will all be forever thankful for his devotion and service as a member, as an elder, over so many years. We will miss him dearly. Bill was a beloved husband, father, son, brother, grandfather, and friend. He was adventurous, daring, and loving. Remember him. Talk of him. Hold him forever in your hearts now that we can say with all faith that he has been welcomed home and greeted by his Savior with the words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Your trials are over. Enter into the joy of your Lord." In a moment, we are going to listen to Bill playing music, offering his gift once again to the world. And as we do, I invite you to take time to remember Bill in your own way. There's an American children's song which goes like this. There is a song that doesn't end. Yes, it goes on and on, my friends. Some people started singing it, not knowing what it was, and they'll continue singing it forever, just because. Bill has gone from this world, but his song has not ended. His life, his love live on in us, and in the end, we will all be with him again, when the Lord calls us each home. Listen now to Bill's Milton Bray. Listen for his song of love, his song of friendship, his song of teaching, his song of presence in your life. Listen for his song playing to you today and forever. Poem, Remember Me. Remember me with smiles, not tears, for all the joy through all the years. Recall the closeness that was ours, a love as sweet as fragrant flowers. Don't dwell on thoughts that cause you pain. We'll see each other once again. I am at peace. Try to believe. It was my time. I had to leave. But what a view I have from here. I see your face. I feel you near. I follow you throughout the day. You're not alone along the way. And when God calls you, you will be right by my side, right here with me. Till then, I'll wait by heaven's door. We'll be united evermore. Let us pray. Almighty God, you are the author of life. You deliver our eyes from tears, our feet from falling, and our souls from death. God of all love, protector, carer, comforter, as we come before you in prayer, we give thanks for the life of your Son, Jesus, in whom death's power is broken forever, who walked where we walked, loved as we love, died as we die, and rose to life again in glory, promising eternal life for all who follow him. Grant us the peace of Christ in this difficult time. God of grace, we praise you for the great company of the faithful whom Jesus has brought through death to see your face in glory, and for those among them whom we have known and loved, especially your servant Bill. We praise you for all the tender and precious memories that he leaves behind now that you have called him to yourself. We thank you for Bill's life, for the lasting impact he has left on the lives of so many, for the joy he gave and had with his family, for his immense generosity, for his humility, for his compassion, for his music, for the light that he was in the lives of those closest to him. We give thanks. To your loving care, we commend all those who grieve today. We pray especially for those who will miss Bill the most, all those who shared in his life, for his beloved wife Jean, and his sons Roy and Dawn, Hallie and Carol, his daughters-in-law, for Jack, Charlie, Annie and Emma, his beloved grandchildren, for his extended family and friends, and for all who knew and loved him, that they will each find comfort in you and their love for each other. Sustain them in the days to come with treasured memories of the past and radiant hopes for the future. We remember, too, those who have gone before Bill, who he is now reunited with in love for eternity, especially his brother Robert. Help us to walk amid the things of this world with our eyes wide open to your glory. Make us sure in every sorrow that you are still loving us, sure in every darkness that you are still guiding us, sure in death that you are giving us life forevermore. Eternal God, in your compassion, console those who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered into the company of all your saints in the glory of your everlasting kingdom. And this we pray in the name of our Savior Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you all for joining together today to give thanks for the life of Bill. The family would like to thank all those who were part of Bill's life. And any donations that anyone would like to make will be gratefully received for the British Heart Foundation after the service in the foyer. And all are welcome to join the family at the Gilvan Bank Hotel following the interment. And the family invite anyone who is unable to go to the cemetery to go straight to the hotel. After this funeral service, we will journey on with Bill to his resting place in St. Drostan's Cemetery. Our lives are like music. We walk through this earth, leaving our mark and leaving our sound, leaving a memory, a tale, a whispered secret, a silly moment, heartfelt encounters and relationships that all remain and endure forever. The song does not end upon our death. It changes. It is carried on by those who remain. We have spent this afternoon remembering Bill, holding stories of him close, but let them not be confined to this time or this place. Take them with you. Carry them out into the world. Talk of him often. Let his name never be far from your lips. Be grateful that you had the honor, the gift of knowing him, and keep him with you every day of your life. Let us stand and sing together our next and final hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Thank you.
So we prepare to go now, and as we do, the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, guard your hearts and your thoughts in Christ Jesus, and the blessing of God Almighty descend upon you and rest with you this day and all days. Amen.